I would encourage the members to defeat this amendment for the simple reason that it is inadequate to do what needs to be done. The task has been identified, and it's time that we as members of the House trust those folks that are giving us the advice that we should be taking. Namely, the Secretary of Transportation. There was not one, not two, not three, but four task force have identified repeatedly that we need at least $2.2 to $2.5 billion to solve our problem. The worst thing we can do, in my opinion, Mr. Speaker, is vote for something that's half a loaf, because you're going to be back here in 2 years trying to fix the other half of the loaf. And while I respect what the gentleman is trying to do, and that is offer a solution that seems more palatable at the gas pumps, and while I have never been one to want to vote for increases for consumers who use our roads, the plain and simple reality is that the federal government and their lack of funding of federal highways have left states strapped for cash. Mr. Speaker, we spend $600 million of funds that could be used for transit and road projects to maintain our interstates because the federal government and the transportation fund are broke. Mr. Speaker, it is my prediction that more and more you will find states having to go to the federal government to ask for authority in order to toll those roads because it is a common problem for all our states. Now, Mr. Speaker, I find very interesting tonight the dichotomy and the debate. Every single business group, every single one in my community is writing to me asking that we pass the previous bill and the previous amendment offered by the representative from Delaware County. And while it was defeated, I have to scratch my head to wonder why it is that every business group in my community would be asking for more revenue in the nature of that amendment. And it occurred to me that because they probably realize that for their workforce to get to their work, they need mass transit. I also, you know, I rarely take mass transit, but it also occurred to me that if I'm trying to get into Center City and 95 is jammed because there is no mass transit, it's going to be pretty tough for me to get into the city and conduct my business. Mr. Speaker, I have elderly who go and use transit in order to get to their doctor's appointments. Mr. Speaker, we have heard that both the Warminster and Doylestown lines will be closed. You want to talk about mass bedlam. This amendment, unfortunately, does not provide and cannot provide sufficient revenue to take care of our roads and our projects. In one of my communities, I have $15 million of urgent need projects just to relieve the communities of congestion. This bill will not create that kind of funding in order to accomplish those tasks. And you know, there are a couple roads and intersections in Bucks County that quite frankly give me chills. One I'm thinking about, a number of young men and women take every day of their lives. And if we don't fix this, it's like a kamikaze run. Where is our responsibility, Mr. Speaker, in this House chambers to try and create the safety conditions that we need? We heard a lot tonight about bridges, and bridges are a concern, but our roads are in desperate need. Lastly, Mr. Speaker, this amendment will not provide the funding to our local communities that they're asking for in order to fix local township and municipal roads. Mr. Speaker, the last amendment, had it passed, would have provided an immediate 10% increase this year and for the next 6 years, for a total of a 60% increase in funding for our local roads. That's the issue I hear the most about, Mr. Speaker, and unfortunately, I have to ask the members to defeat this amendment. It's inadequate, and we will be back here voting for additional measures very shortly if this were to pass. Thank you.